Hello, Minecraftians. This episode was going to be about crafting better foods, but since I haven't gotten a cow yet, and I realized that I put that directly over my squid spawner slash pool, so I might fill in that a bit. Actually, I will for sure, because I don't need squids right now, and I do need cows. But we're going to proceed on the blood magic front, because we can get cows that way. Because we were lucky enough to get a couple of horses, and they gave us leather, which we would need to turn into a spawn cow egg. And we can finally get along with those other spawn egg quests from earning the sky block. That should be tall enough for them not to spawn. Oh, where am I going here? So we are going to build a blood altar this episode, and because I don't like redesigning things later on, I'm going to do it from the start. Actually, I need a third type of block. Oh, well, I'll use two different kinds of wood. I'll use this wood for the special bits. And I'm working based off of a picture, so if it turns out weird, it's entirely my fault. I did build this before, but it's been a while, you know? And we also want some stairs. Don't have much cobble left. I'm gonna take that actually. I'll put three back. No, I'll keep the three. What do we want to make stairs out of? Ideally, I would make it out of. Where are they? Out of the wood from these blood saplings. But I'm not. I don't think I have the technology to effectively mine these yet. That could be for next episode, or one after. I didn't decide. I guess we'll make it out of these. No. We need another type. Another type of block. Get rid of that. Gold stairs? Is that a thing? Iron stairs? Don't have any more just building material. I guess we'll make them cobble stairs for now. And I'll go get more cobble. We're going to need a lot more stairs than this. This is a big thing. It is gigantic. Actually, what I want to do here is set up this other guy. So I'm going to need a lot more cobble. I'll just put it there. And we'll grab one of these. Go. All right. Back to this. And we're gonna fill out the bottom. Ooh, almost fell. One, two, three, and then five, two, three, four, five, and then one, to add a cobble. I should really do it from the top stage down. Actually, I'll be right back. I'm gonna figure out the dimensions of this and then we'll continue. We are back and I've decided to build it from the top down. So we are 3 blocks up here. And I think that's gonna be all we need. 1, 2, 3, yeah. So the jungle wood is gonna be blood runes eventually. And the cobble we don't care about. Cobble can be anything. And then there's gonna be stairs that, these stairs, they don't need to be here, but I like having stairs. And I'd like them to be red eventually because this is a blood altar, so we want everything to be red. And let's just get rid of this stuff. I do really hope that I got these dimensions right. I have a feeling I might be one wrong on the width, which would be disastrous, of course. So we're just gonna build out this corner, I think, first, just to make sure we got it right. So we've got that, and then cobble comes down. And then this is a pillar. And the pillar has stuff around it. Like so. And on this level, we've got more jungle wood. And then that comes down and out one, like this. Wait a second, so this is the glowstone pillar. Oh no, I missed one. Let's take this stuff out. So this is the glowstone pillar. And then this one will be that pillar. So the stairs will be here. And then there's going to be stairs here. Oops. You can rotate these with a wrench, I believe. There we go. It's off by one. Nuts. All right, I'm gonna tear this down. I need to move it over here. I'll be back when. And we're back. So we're gonna have stone around this main pillar. And I'm starving again. Good enough. Stone here. And then this is going to be the pillar. This pillar will have... Oh, these things will be... jungle wood. And then there will be steps on these. Did I do this wrong again? Nope, I did not. Okay, I did it right. Wonky looking structure, and we're gonna fill it in with cobble. Oh, I do believe that this is actually a jungle wood. And then we get steps out here. There we go. That's right. So I'm gonna keep filling this out and show you guys the final product. Be right back. Back a little bit just to give you guys dimensions. So this top bit is a 3x3 with the middle block not mattering because there's going to be something on top of it called a blood altar, just a block that is a blood altar. This whole thing is going to be a multi-block structure that makes up a better tier blood altar. So the first wall has three blood runes and a space for steps on each side. So 5x5 is the top layer. The second one has 5 runes on each side, an empty block for a pillar, and then a layer of steps around that. So that is 8x8. 5 plus 2 plus 2. 9x9, sorry. And then the next layer after that has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it should be 7, 7 blood runes. Is that right? No, it's not. It should be 9. Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 is under here. So 9 blood runes, space for a pillar, and one more step, or two steps. Yep. At the outmost anyways. There's going to be this little gap here that doesn't matter. So 9 plus 2, 4, 6 is 13 by 13. That's the third level down. And the last one is going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Of those, and then there's going to be a beacon on each side, which is what this thing represents. It needs to be at least a tier 1 beacon. You can go down further and expand it to be a higher tier beacon, but I'm not going to. So that's 13 plus 6 is 19 by 19 is the overall area you're going to need for the bottom. And it's going to be a total of a whole bunch of blood runes. But I'm not going to fill this out with blood runes right away. I'm going to do it by tiers because you can get better blood runes as you go along. So I'll be right back once I get this fully finished. And it doesn't matter if you fill in the bottom here, but I'm going to anyways. So I'll be right back. Alright guys, I am back and fully finished this. I even replaced the edges with iron for the beacons. Need a bit more border stone to complete that line, but eh. And just once more, any of the cobble in this is unnecessary, except for the parts on the pillars. They need to have some kind of solid block under what will replace the wood blocks. The inner circle of them will be glowstone. The outer circle will be something called bloodstone, which we will get to making eventually. But first things first, actually, we're going to do this like super legit, exactly how it says in Hero Wizard Steve. So we need to make a Thaumonomicon and a Sacrificial Orb. Now, I believe this text actually tells you how to do this stuff. Start with a bookshelf and a wand. Right click your wand on the bookshelf to create a Thaumonomicon. And so on and so forth. But we're going to do the Sacrificial Orb first, I think. Which is just glass, iron, and gold. Should have all that stuff in here. Glass. You can get iron and gold. Nope, other way. There we go. And we're gonna need some bookshelves, which I think is 3 of these. Oh man, my mouse is being a bit funky today. 3. And then some wood around that to make a bookshelf. Now we need a wand. Iron nuggets and a stick. And we're gonna need 2. There's those, and now we just need a stick. Perfect. And we're just going to right click with this. We're going to take some damage. And it should... Oh, no, it's not bound to us. Never mind. Other things we'll do that with. So you want to place your bookshelf down. And right click it with the wand. And it becomes this awesome looking book called the Thaumonomicon. We aren't going to get into this much now, but this is going to be a big part of our lives later on. This Sky Alchemy tab is how we get around most of the stuff for not having a world to dig, and these things spawned in. That's cool. Anyways, we're going to put that away. And we're going to continue. Actually, we'll put the wand away too. That's this one done. We're going to take the Rune of Sacrifice. The Rune of Self-Sacrifice will boost how much life points you get from using the Sacrificial Orb to sacrifice your own life. Whereas the Rune of Sacrifice will increase how much you get for sacrificing other things, which is what we're going to do much later on, so we might as well get that. The Rune of Self-Sacrifice is good early on, but we don't really need it. Let's be honest. We don't want to be sacrificing ourselves too much. 14 lives and a greater reward bag. Pearl oysters. That is a good find for mariculture. We'll just put them away for now. And these blood runes. All of the jungle bits here can be replaced with blood runes. And there are many different kinds of blood runes. There are 8, in fact. The default blood rune, which is the easiest to make. And then most of these are upgraded ones. And things like... well, we'll get to this later, but... these three are harder to make. Let's just go with that. Yep. But next, we're going to go in here, make a blood altar. Cool, we can do this. Wait for some things to smelt. One more. There we go. Blood altar. And does that complete this quest? You have to get a weak blood orb. And that's blood orbs. These are different levels of blood orbs. The weak blood orb is the first tier one. You can see, if you click on it, it requires a tier one blood altar and 2,000 LP. And the next one requires tier two and 5,000, tier three and 25,000, tier four and tier five. And these are some funky... well, the last two require some blood magic specific items to craft. I want to find a good way of lighting this area up. But first, I think, we need a diamond. And I'll grab an emerald as well. We won't be able to use the emerald immediately, but... oh, perfect. We're going to hopefully get to this emerald today. And have I been recording that long? What you're going to want to do is stand near this and fill it up with 10 hearts worth. 7, 8, 9, 10. You can do that slower so you don't get injured. This the blood altar will hold 10,000 LP just fine. There's no decay rate on it, but it won't hold any more than 10,000. And we'll just do one more for good measure, and then stick in the diamond. It spins around, it has this funky effect on it. And of the various runes, The speed rune and the sacrifice rune aren't going to be what you use most often. The efficiency rune, I think, is outdated now. The speed rune will increase how fast. Uh-oh. Hopefully that's enough. Do I have any of... No, I don't have them on me. Let's quickly eat something. If it does that effect, it's really bad because it means it's losing life points already given. There we go. Whew. So maybe a bit more than 10,000 worth. And this is one that you have to right click in the sky with. It'll take a bit of damage, but now it says current owner me. And you need that in order to be able to use it for things. What you can do now is stick it in there and it'll suck up all of the remaining blood and put it into my blood network. Each blood alchemist has his own blood network. And there's no way to transfer life points between them. And... manual detect. Claim reward. Divination sigil is gonna be the bomb. Beef jerky. Eh. What we're gonna do eventually is probably off this side. We're gonna set up a villager spawner trap kind of thing. That will push villagers into this block. When we sacrifice things to the blood altar, they have to be within two blocks. That was kind of a hiccup while talking. They have to be within 2 blocks of the actual blood altar block. So it's gonna kind of like, it's probably gonna like fill in part of this blood altar, but we'll worry about that later. It won't negatively impact how this thing determines its level, the tier. Nope. Let's go back and search for divination. Or we can just do sigil. Since there's a bunch of sigils that blood magic offers, we're going to need a blank slate, which is 1,000 LP. So 5 taps with this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for good measure. And a piece of smooth stone. I'm just going to craft 10 more of those. Come on, give me one. Give me one. That's good enough. And put just one in. If you put a hopper on the side of this, you can have more than one item in there at a time. It'll just take all of the blood to do each one. Like, it would have taken twice as much blood with 2, or 3 times as much blood with 3, before anything changes. I don't really like that as much. I'd rather have... rather have them like done one at a time, but that's just me. So we're gonna put that stuff in there. Search divination sigil, and there. All right, it can't do the orb thing. I'm not sure why. Oh, possibly because the one in the recipe isn't owned by anyone. That would explain it. So this divination sigil, if you right click it in the air, it'll show you how much essence is in your blood network. And you can also right click on this blood altar and it'll tell you the tier and how much essence is currently in it. So if I sacrifice myself here, You can see it goes from 200 to 400, and the capacity is 10,000. You can upgrade the capacity, but I haven't found it very useful in the past. So what we need to do next is, I guess, choose power or lengthening. We'll go with lengthening. These catalysts I use for potion making. You can make them longer or more powerful, but none of them are too difficult to make anyways. And the blood alchemy set, we're gonna need that. And we're also gonna need to upgrade the altar. I just wanna check which one is more difficult to make, the sacrifice rune or the speed rune. The sacrifice rune is more difficult. Fluxed Electrum. Yikes. So we're gonna make a regular blood rune, which is done with 2 stone. Need 1 more stone. And we'll eat this heart while we're here. 16 lives. That's 1,000, 2, 3, 4, 5. That should be 2,000. Alright, so we don't have to worry about them running out now. You have to be empty-handed to get items out of it. And if you want to, you can keep right-clicking and watch it drain, but yeah, it's not really necessary. And yep, it's down to 0. And room. We just need that, some stone. I guess you use a lot of stone in blood magic. I never thought about it before. And the blood orb to get this guy. And we're going to take the rune of sacrifice. Two enderfish. Interesting. We're going to put those away. 17 lives now. I really should check how long this episode is getting, because I think it's been a while. I've been up for 2 hours and recording the whole time, I think, except for some off-camera stuff. Alright, so we're gonna finish this quickly, right after we open this bag. Wooden fishing rod. Well, useless. And next we want to do a larger orb. Ritual stones are more difficult to get than blood stones. The ritual stones are used for larger rituals, which do more powerful things like summoning demons or causing sacrifices to be automatically done in an area or healing everything in an area. And all rituals require or take blood from your blood network. Blood slash LP. LP and blood are the same thing. Let's refer to them that way. We do want to upgrade this. I think I will teach it how to do some things. I'm gonna put this in here. I won't put it in there yet. Let's teach it how to make speed runes. Oh, it's not gonna know how to make... That's... Well, never mind then. Eventually I might integrate this with the blood altar. 'Cause it gonna need to craft things in the Blood Altar to get other things, but we'll see. We'll see about that. Alright, so for now we need 4 blood runes. We'll just do that. 4 blood runes will require 8 stone. It's probably waiting on a cobble too. Yep. And we'll smelt these here. Oop. Oh, one more. There we go. Now we can sacrifice ourselves to the blood gods. And we're at 0 right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Do 6 for now. 5 should be enough to get a thing. We're just gonna grab the regeneration potion here. Unless I have... Oh, that's so much better. Regeneration for 7 minutes. Yes, please. And put these in. Actually, we'll take out those. How many is that? 2,400. There we go. That's enough for 3. Two, three, four, five. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, because I think they did that wrong. Sorry if I mumble occasionally. I'm trying to work on that. It's one of those things I don't like about myself right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that should be enough to make 2 more. So we do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1 more will do it. One, two, three, four, five. That should be all the blood we need. Yep, 2,000, that's perfect. Almost there. There we go. This should let us upgrade to tier 5. Or tier 2. Tier 5. Tier 5 is nuts. Now, the basic blood runes don't actually do anything to help us. They're just there to complete the level. Yeah, it says tier 2 now. And if you take out one of these, it'll say tier 1. Put it back, and it'll say tier 2. Nice. So now we can do this with 5,000 life points, which is that what we need for the next bit? No, we need the next level above that. Which requires gold and more LP than can be held in this thing at one time. So before we do that, we're going to have to get some sacrifices going on. Which means I'm going to need to spawn a villager. Oh, but what am I thinking? We wanted some cows. Spawn cow is just that. A leather, which we have some of from killing horses. And one of these. 1, 2, 3. We'll make all three. Because why not? We're going to keep these cows alive too. We won't be killing them. And I believe we can do some other things in here now. Chicken and squid we need. Chicken is a feather. We're only going to do one of these because we only need one. And what is squid? Squid requires the alchemic chemistry set. Let's look up how to make that. Oh, we need another brewing stand. It's a good thing I have that thing. Manual detect that before we accidentally throw it. It's gonna be the last thing for this episode, I swear. We need one of these. Should have enough for that. Oh, right. Do I have it on me? Of course I don't. Oh, we've got a whole bunch of pigs over here now. And there it is. I'll put both of them in. I don't remember getting three, but I guess I must have. Or, no, one was probably a quest reward. Brew. And then we need some of this. Alright. And blood orb. Yeah. Take that out. And we'll put this. The alchemic chemistry set uses blood straight from your LP, from your blood network, so it doesn't have to be anywhere in specific. And this can also be automated, but you need a rune around it to automate, not a rune, a ritual. So this is the, let's just look up the spawn. I need 2 raw fish and a fishing rod. What I was talking about is that you have to have Do I have any raw fish? Probably not. We're gonna have to do some fishing. Feels so lame manually fishing. I could have fished in my squid pool actually, now that I think about it. But oh well. So we're gonna put the 2 fish there. How much LP does it use? 200. And we have 478 in the network, so that's okay. Now we just need a fishing rod that's full health. Which Actually, I want to check if it will use this damaged one. No, it will not. If it's working, it'll have those red squigglies above it. Oh, we need more. We always need one more stick than we have. Check this out. 48 or 49 slimes already. We've got like 300 string. And I think about 30 ender pearls. Hasn't been too long. Just a couple of hours because I've been offline most of it. Where did I put that? I did not grab it. Spawn squid. Oh, do I need the next tier? Spawn. I might need the next tier. Magicians, masters, archmages. Yep. No weak blood orb. Gotta upgrade. I'm gonna use another swig of regeneration. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That should be 2,000. We just need 3,000, I believe. 1, 2, 3. Four, five. We'll stick that in there. And we'll keep an eye on it. Once you get more blood in it, that blood level will change. It'll go up and down. It'll fill out that whole white bit in the middle there. Or lighter bit. It's still gray, I think. Uh-oh. Right, it needs 5,000. Not 3,000. And it'll take a bit more now because it ran out. There we go. And now we want to bind this to us, and we can stick it back in there. It doesn't matter which blood orb you use in here. All of them will link to your blood network. But I believe that the lower tier ones will only fill your network up to an amount. Like each blood orb you get increases the max capacity of your blood network. And I think if I only charged with the weak blood orb, it would only charge up to the weak blood orb capacity. So you always want to have your top tier one in here, but you can use any. I wonder how much blood I've got now. 1,400. Cool. And we will put the apprentice blood orb in there, and we can see the red squigglies. Shouldn't take too long. There we go. And we're going to grab our orb out of there too. And manual detect. And done. We get a bunch of flowers. And I'll take the third one this time. I think that gives us enough to make another heart. I'm going to store the orbs and the blood stuff in there. Store away the spawn eggs in here for now. In between episodes, I'm gonna spawn these cows and breed them a bunch. We'll put the flowers in their proper place. I thought I put that. Oh, must be for reward. Oh, that's good. See the difference between these two? This one has some essence in it. or is not essence. Are they essence? Aspects. That's it. You can hold shift with it to see the exact number in the top left-hand corner there. It says 25s for all those. Which is the same as if we hover over it. But this will save us, this will let us do one or two basic Chromecraft things in a future episode. I'll put it in here. So I know where it is. And that's going to be it for this time, I think. Nine, 18 lives. And a wooden sword. I'm not going to use Tinker Swords anymore, I think. I'm going to go for something better. Anyways, it was a good long episode today, so we'll see how long this is in post, and I'll probably try to get this up today, Saturday, so that'll complete my two episodes for today. Alright, see you later, guys.